Listen, Ava, I know that you've heard a lot of really bad things about me from, like, everybody, but I'm being straight with you now. Tammy and Sandy do not belong together, and it's only a matter of time before they fall apart.
You don't know that for sure.
Trust me, they're doomed. Can you honestly say that that's not what you want?
It's not. Exactly.
Do you want to be with Sandy?
I love him, and I want him to be happy.
Well, I tell you for a fact, he's not going to be happy with Tammy.
Have you seen the way that she looks at him?
She doesn't love him. Not... Her heart's not in it, and deep down, Sandy knows that.
Well, if that's true, then I can't step aside. I have to say something to him. I have to make him see.
No, you can't do that, because then he's just going to think that you're trying to ruin his life. And that's the same reason I can't tell Tammy that you guys are married.
Because you don't want to hurt her.
I want her to figure it out for herself. Look, sometimes you just got to back off and let them come to you.
Take very long. Help me get some of these tangles out.
I'd be glad to. You got a comb? Can I come in?
Why?
Fine. I'll just stand out here.
Sandy's gonna be back soon.
Yeah, well, the more the merrier. And don't freak out on me. I'll stay on this half of the room. You stay over there and work on that rat's nest.
Why are you here?
Well, I was thinking about what you said to me about how we have to learn to live together in this town, and I'm in.
Why are you really here?
You really don't trust me at all, do you?
This surprises you?
You, better brush that hair before it dries like that.
Are you gonna tell me?
Yeah, I've changed. And to prove it to you, I'm gonna throw you and Sandy an engagement party.
Leave.
I'm serious.
You're crazy.
Yeah, but I have my sentimental side too.
Sandy's not gonna allow it.
Tammy, I need to do this.
Why?
Well, you've made your decision, and I'm not loving it, but you're gonna be Mrs. Sandman, and I have to learn to live with it.
Well, throwing us an engagement party isn't the answer, okay?
Could be.
Jonathan, if you're playing with me...
I'm not playing with you. Look, this might be my last chance to see if you made the right decision.
I did make the right decision, okay? I don't care if you see it or not. You know what? You took what I said about us living together in the same town all wrong, all right?
Did I?
Yes.
You and I are a part of each other's lives. Like it or not, we're gonna run into each other. So let me do this. Help me move on.
No. No party. In fact, nothing, right?
You're not even gonna give me this one little thing.
It's not about you. Don't you see that?
I just want you to be happy.
Then let me go.
I'm trying. You miss this one.
Change my mind. We don't have to wait.
Don't. Don't worry. He's not staying. I told him no. I told him definitely not.
What this time?
I came to throw out the old olive branch. I offered to throw you guys an engagement party at outskirts, but your girlfriend just turned me down flat.
Well, I think a party is a great idea. Thanks, Jonathan.
You think Jonathan throwing us a party is a great idea?
Listen, I know I've caused you guys a lot of grief in the past, but why don't you let me make up for it? What do you say?
Why not? We're solid. We have a great future. It's time to start celebrating.
Right. Tonight's the night, then. It's gonna be fun, huh? Free food, free booze. You should get on the phone and call everybody that you know.
You're right. I better write down names so that I don't forget anyone.
Yes. I really want this to work out for you guys.
Yeah. Well, me too. Don't forget to put Josh and Reva on the list.
On the top.
Perfect. All right, well, I'll see you guys whenever you get there.
Relax, this'll be fun.
If you say so.
I can't wait for the whole world to know you said yes to me and that you are gonna be my wife.
Jonathan has a lot of rough edges, you know. Hard edges, sharp edges. More edges than I really care to count, but you see underneath all that, don't you? So, maybe you could give him a chance.
Can we talk about something else?
It's just that he had a really rough time when he was growing up. You know, he had himself believing some things about who he is and who he'll never be, and you put up barriers in your head. I just understand what that can do to a person, you know. It can hold you down, it can hold you back. And it forces you to want to lash out at the world. And when Jonathan first came to Springfield, he did that with anyone who he could get close enough to, being Josh and me, his cousin Tammy.
His what? Did you just say his cousin Tammy?
Yeah, why?
Related. I didn't know they were related. John never mentioned it to me.
Yeah, Tammy's my niece, my sister Cassie's girl.
Hey, you! Not you. You, back to work. Come on, this place is gonna be crawling with weirdos in less than an hour.
Oh, you mean the usual crowd?
No, private party, I'm throwing it. And yes, y'all invited to Mama Sol.
Gosh, a last minute Halloween party. Scary.
Half Halloween, all scary.
Half Halloween party? What the heck's a half Halloween party?
It's a celebration, too.
Of? What
else? The engagement.
Engagement? What engagement? Whose?
Tammy and Sandy. Let's go. Let's show them a good time.
You're throwing a party to celebrate Sandy and Tammy's engagement?
Yeah, why not?
You really expect me to answer that question? What is going on, Jonathan?
Reva, hey, I'm tired of being the problem that this family has to overcome, so I want to show you guys that I can be a part of you. All treats, no tricks. I promise. Now, come on. You need to, give me some room here. I have things to do to get this party ready. You get out of my way. You come back, you're gonna be so proud of what your little boy did.
I'm not buying this.
Go out! Out! Hey, I heard Joshua RSVP'd, so you better hurry back. See, it's just like I said, peace and forgiveness. And most of all, true love will be in the air. What else would you like to tell me?
Well, I signed the divorce papers, gave them to Sandy.
Congratulations. You gave the guy just what he wanted, and now he'll trust you, so You be his friend and you show him how much you care, and I think that he'll figure out that he was a lot better off with you in his life.
Spoke to your mom earlier.
Yeah, so?
Yeah, she seems to think that you're in love with me. Now, how is she gonna feel when she finds out the girl you really want is your cousin Tammy?
Riva told you that Tammy and I are cousins.
She mentioned it to me.
So do you think that it's the cousin thing that's keeping us apart? Do you think that's why Tammy and I aren't together?
Isn't it?
No. It's me. It's who I am. It's the things I do that drive her away. But it's the same things about me that always keep her coming back.
Hey, boss.
Nice. Nice outfit.
Yeah, well, I'm not gonna hang around, so you can aim me at Sandy like some kind of weapon while you grab at Tammy. Don't tell me you're not interested in her.
Mm.
I'm just glad it's my night off.
No, Ava, you can't leave. Come here. When I made the schedule, I didn't know it was going to be a full house. I need you here.
Yeah, to help you hurt Sandy?
No, I'm throwing this party because I believe...
You believe what?
I believe that guests of honor have arrived. Hey, you made it. Congratulations. Happy hollow engagement.
Thanks. You know, the place really does look great. You worked fast.
Well, it's all in your honor. I just hope that your guests start showing up soon.
Everyone we called was a yes.
You look...
Thanks. You make a nice couple, huh?
You know, I'm gonna grab us some champagne.
Wait, Sam...
You two enjoy yourselves. Be right back. Ava. I didn't know you'd be here. I thought you were off tonight.
Jonathan needed extra hands. What can I get you?
I wish you would stop staring.
I'm just staring at you, staring at me.
I'm just waiting for you to say something.
Well, maybe I do have something I want to say, Tammy. That all this tonight, it's for you.
Me and Sandy, right?
And I hope that it's a great night. For you. And that's all.
That's all.
That's all.
Can you feel it? Every time I look at you, I feel like light is pouring out of me and wrapping us up. And now I know that it's only gonna get brighter. Year after year, brighter.
That's really expensive stuff.
Yep. So, do I know how to throw a party or what?
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 Everybody's having a good time.
Oh, yeah, like us, right? Standing across the room, watching, pretending we're happy. They're so happy. Everybody's so happy.
Who's pretending?
We are. And it's really painful. But somehow you like that.
Keeps you focused. Hey, thought you two could use these.
Oh.
It's the really good stuff. It's a special bottle for special occasions.
Well, good. It's a perfect time for a toast. Yeah, yeah. Everybody, I'd like to take a minute to talk about my favorite subject. Tammy? I never knew how happy I could be until this woman came into my life. She makes... every day beautiful. That's just who she is. We've been through some tough times, but they all brought us here, and here we are. No more obstacles, Tammy. We've conquered all of them. They're behind us forever now. Today is a day for celebrating what's good in our lives and what's to come. To you and me. Just you and me.
was a beautiful toast.
Thank you. I meant every word of it. She is amazing.
Hey.
Hey.
You enjoying yourself?
It's a really nice party, Jonathan. Thank you so much for this. And for finally...
Finally what?
Understanding.
I understand everything.
Everything.
More than I'm saying, more than you want to hear.
How's my beautiful bride-to-be?
Actually, I'm thirsty.
Well, we'll have to fix that, won't we? And then maybe how about a long, slow dance? I know the host, so maybe he'll turn down the lights for us.
Hey, everyone! Grab a glass of something. My turn to make a toast to the happy couple.
Jonathan.
Does everyone have a glass, Ava? Go make sure they do. Go ahead. To Tammy and Sandy. They are one happy couple. They are a beautiful couple. They are a one-of-a-kind couple. What could anyone say about Tammy and Sandy that hasn't already been said? Well, I'll tell you what. A whole hell of a lot. Everybody grab a glass of something. It's my turn to toast the happy couple.
Jonathan.
Ava, does everybody have a glass? Please make sure that they do. Let's go to Tammy and Sandy. A happy couple, a beautiful couple, a one-of-a-kind couple. What could I possibly say about Tammy and Sandy that hasn't already been said? Well, as it turns out, folks, a whole hell of a lot. Sandy Foster. What can I say about you, man? You and I were best friends in boarding school for a while anyway. And we definitely had our rough patches. There was a little incident on a mountain, but that's the past, I hope. I think everyone in this room would have to agree that they didn't trust Sandy for a while.
Hi. Sorry I'm late. What did I miss?
Now we all know that we were off the mark. You're a good man, Sandy. And Tammy, all I've ever wanted for you is happiness. Someone who will put you first, because that's what you deserve. So, here's to the happy couple.
Wait! There's something I need to say to you. I just want to say how happy I am that you're all here with me and Sandy this evening to celebrate our engagement. We've had a pretty tough year. But this marriage is going to put all the hard stuff behind us. And any new challenges that come up, Sandy and I are going to face them together as husband and wife. I'm so happy right now. I'm so hopeful for the future because of you.
Good toast. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
To my beautiful fiance.
Oh my gosh, we missed it.
This song is for you, for us.
Jonathan,
What are you doing? This is Tammy and Sandy's dance.
Well, then let's share in their joy.
Having a good time?
The best. You?
I'm a happy man. Jonathan did a good thing here. How'd that happen? We have a whole future together to look forward to. Just you and me. Forever.
Forever.
Just let go, but how do you stop loving someone just because everyone tells you it's bad for you?
I don't know. You throw a great party, and I think that you did a really decent thing today, trying to make Tammy and Sandy happy. Thank you.
Oh, sure. I just want what's best for both of them, so.
Where are Tammy and Sandy?
How should I know? I'm not their keeper.
You know what? I don't get you. You say that you want Tammy all to yourself. And instead of telling her that Sandy's already married to me and blowing him out of the water, you decide to help me get a divorce and then throw them an engagement party?
If you love something, you set it free.
Yeah, that's what you keep saying, but I can't help but think there's something else going on.
Well, all I know is that if two people are meant for each other, then nothing and no one can keep them apart.
I'm gonna get my car, okay?
Ava.
You guys leaving?
Yeah. I want to thank you for giving me the divorce and making this possible.
Just want you guys to be happy.
May I kiss the bride?
All set?
Let's go home.
Thanks again, Jonathan.
Anytime.
This is so strange.
It's okay. Everything will work out the way it should. You think Tammy is gonna be happy with Sandy?
Busy? Marina, I have every minute planned between now and this wedding. Like today. Sandy and I are meeting with the minister this morning, and then this afternoon, I have an appointment at the dress warehouse. But it's okay. I'm cool. I know exactly how I want this wedding to go. I have it all planned out in my head. There'll be lots of pink, but it won't be too girly or fussy. Simple and elegant. Just like the dress. I know exactly what I want. Something romantic, traditional. Mom and Jeffrey will be there, as happy as I've ever seen them. Then when the music starts, Uncle Josh will take my arm.
then walk me down the aisle. And down at the end, waiting for me, will be my groom. The man I love. The man I love.
What? Yeah. I'm still here.
But I have to go.
Yeah, all these plans.
You know, if there was a day that you and I, we kept things light. We traveled real light. We had that no strings attached kind of thing. And we didn't have any expectations on one another. And we got to do lots of fun things and great things. And I don't know, maybe we should do some more of those things. Get it? You're not a Boy Scout. You're in love. Ever since you were a little girl, you had this knack for picking up people's spirits whenever they were down.
Yeah, right.
You did! It's true, I'm telling you. Do you know, when you were about a year old, I lost this job that I really needed. And when I came home, I just felt like my life was over. And that was the day you took your first step. And then I felt like my life was starting all over again. See?
Well, I'm sure it was just a coincidence.
Maybe, but it happened over and over and over again. You've got something, girl. You do. You really, really affect people. Even Jonathan.
Jonathan?
Yeah, I ran into him at Outskirts, and he is really happy for you and Sandy, and he thinks that you deserve this happiness, so that's how strong your power is. You even affected Jonathan.
So, when did it exactly happen to you, Jonathan? When did it get you?
Goodbye, Dinah.
Okay. Who's a lucky girl?
Look, it's none of your business.
Aha! I am right. You're in love. Hey, it's nothing to be ashamed of. Scared of, maybe, considering how much can mess you up, but I think that love can be a wonderful thing. I've heard that anyway. Look, whatever happens, I think that, you know, the next step, I mean, you gotta just make sure that you admit to yourself that it's happened to you.
Well, I didn't ask for it to happen.
What is the problem?
She's with somebody else.
Of course. I'm gonna tell you something. You cut that loose.
Just like that?
Just like that. Jonathan, I have fallen in love twice in my life. The first time, the guy ended up dead. The second time, I almost did. Then the guy almost did.
That's a lot of dead people.
Disaster. Both times. You know why? Because I thought I was second best.
Well, I'm not second best.
Well, that's what I thought. But let me tell you something. You get out of this while you can.
It's too late.
When did you talk to Jonathan? What were you doing at Outskirts?
Well, I had a problem at the Beacon, and he actually helped me. And he was really nice, if you can believe that. Do you want some jam?
And he said what about me and Sandy?
He hopes you guys are very happy.
Those were his exact words.
Yeah, something like that. He seemed to genuinely care.
That's nice.
Well, that just goes to show you that you, just being you, can even affect some twisted soul like Jonathan.
Mom, he has been hurt really badly.
Yeah, well, so have you. At his hand. And what he did to you. Honey, there aren't even words for that. But, come here.
You know what amazes me? It comforts me. It's that you haven't changed at all. Not deep down. You are still that sweet, beautiful little girl that you always have been.
What if I'm not the same person? What if I did change? I mean, I grew up, right? Enough to get married.
I'm so proud of you. I am, you know, and you just give us all hope.
Don't. Mom, I want to be all those things, a beacon, an inspiration to you and to Sandy, but I don't know if I can.
Why not? What's wrong?
I am.
What's going on?
I try so hard, Mom. I really do.
Oh, come sit down.
I don't want to sit. I just want...
What? What's going on?
I just want to know that I can do this.
We get married?
When Sandy was in the hospital, I made a promise to God that I'd be good and do everything right as long as he walked out of there alive.
And he did walk out alive, and you do everything right, honey.
No, I'm not. I'm not at all. I'm screwing up.
Okay, what are you doing that you shouldn't be doing? What?
I lost my engagement ring. I have a dress fitting to go to, and...
I'll find it for you. Got it. Nice ring.
Please, give it back.
You're busy. Wedding. Stressful. I don't want to add to the list of things that you have to deal with.
Really?
What?
You're not going to tell me that I'm making a huge mistake? That I don't belong with Sandy, but I do belong with you?
Is that what you want me to say?
Why are you doing this?
What?
Trying to get me to admit.
What?
Nothing. Marrying Sandy is the best decision I've ever made in my life.
Good for you.
What are you doing?
What do you want from me, Tammy? I just said, look, you probably just made the best decision of your life. Good for you. I want you to be happy. You just don't trust me.
No. We both know how you really feel, so why bother pretending you feel something else?
Look, Tammy, I've done nothing but tell you where I think you belong. That you should follow your guts and your heart and not your brain. I'm not gonna do that anymore. You love Sandy? Fine. Love him. Marry him.
I'm going to. I made a promise.
Again, good for you. I'm not gonna mess with any of that.
I don't understand.
There's nothing to understand.
You're really okay with me being happy with someone else?
Okay, well, I guess so, because what other choice do I have?
But I thought you...
What? Tammy, what would we have if we were together? Honestly, people would talk about us everywhere we went.
Since when do you care what people think?
Oh, they'd be right. You know what they would say about us, and they'd be right. You don't want that. You've been running away from me from the start anyway. You want something safe and stable. You want Sandy. We could never work out anyway, and you know it. Don't you? You think I'm playing you? What you want out of life is something that is entirely different than anything that I could ever give you.
Well, I never said that.
I make you feel miserable. I make you have to look over your shoulder. I make you feel dirty.
You also saved my life.
Yeah, and I would do it again in a heartbeat.
That has to count for something, right?
I would break your heart just as fast. And we both know that. You don't have to sit there pretending that I deserve some benefit of the doubt. When it comes to you, I don't deserve anything.
Jonathan. You didn't mean to hurt me.
I know, but that's what always seems to happen.
You don't try to.
I know. Look, it's like I can't help myself. You need to be with Sandy. With him, you'd be safe. If you were with Sandy, then your life would never even need saving.
JB! I don't think you ever really meant to hurt me. And I don't think it's automatic that you would again. In fact, I know you wouldn't. You couldn't. Not if we... We were...
What? Not if we were what?
Oh, God. I have to go. I have to meet my mom at the Beacon in Edmond, and I have to go to the bridal warehouse and...
Shh. Just go. And stop looking back. Just go and keep going.
Hey, what's wrong?
I just remembered something that I never should have forgotten.
Tammy, are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, it's just all these details. I feel like my head's gonna explode.
Well, if it does, you know what? I'll put it all back together again, because that's what mothers do.
I have to go.
What? Already?
Yeah. Well, you know the bridal place hates it when you're late, so I'll see you there.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Bye, sweetie.
Bye.
Hey, I already know why you're calling. I'll bring it right over.
Just leave it with the front desk at my mom's hotel, okay? Please.
Sure.
Miss Winslow, that is just brilliant. You are a vision.
Thank you. Do you think you could take it up a little?
Of course. Just let me get the veil. Oh, I'm afraid it's across the street.
Oh, take your time. I need to get used to looking like this anyway.
May I kiss the bride?
You made a promise, Tammy. More than that, this is what you need. This is what will give you a happy life. You're keeping up your end of the bargain. Sandy's alive and well. But could you help me keep my vow to him? I don't mean the vows we're about to take. I'm talking about these thoughts in my head. They're not about Sandy. I mean, they are, but could you erase them? Help me never think about Jonathan again. Find a veil. Oh, good, a candle. Okay.
I wish you didn't love
me. Better.
A little. Make this easy.
It was all the kind. Now where's my handsome prince to come and rescue me?
Now it's fear that keeps me with you. I wanna be.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
That's an easy one. So, that's your wedding dress?
Well, we need some alterations.
Looks fine to me.
What are you doing here?
Well, I know that you told me to drop the ring off for you at the beacon, but I don't trust that guy at the desk, so...
Thanks.
You called?
No. It's just that when I was little, I was really afraid of the dark, and I guess I still am a little bit. And those bars make me feel really trapped. There was a saleswoman here, but she went to the warehouse and she didn't come back.
Well, I guess that means you got the dress for free.
Jonathan.
What?
Get me out of here. Please.
I don't know if I can. This thing is shut pretty tight.
Please, I don't want to be in here anymore.
What do you mean you don't want to be locked up with all the white and the lace and the promise of a big, beautiful wedding?
No.
Wait. The lights are all off out there. It's not safe outside. And again, maybe it's not safe in here.
I should take this dress off. I mean, change back into my clothes so that I don't get this dirty. And then we should go.
Wait, turn around for me. I'm not gonna be at the wedding, so it's my chance to see the bride.
I don't look anything like I'm gonna look that day. My hair's not up.
It doesn't matter.
There are pins in the back, and I don't have the veil or in the right shoes. Oh, I forgot to go and pick up the shoes. I keep making lists, and still I keep forgetting things. Sandy and I haven't picked out music or even discussed our vows.
Aren't the vows, like, the most important part?
Yes. It takes a lot of thought to say what you want to say. I've written some stuff down, but none of it's good.
Well, have you tried saying it out loud? Sometimes that helps, so you can hear the way that the words are going to sound.
You think?
Yeah, do you remember anything that you wrote down?
Some of it.
Practice on me.
What?
What? What? There's no one here, and you're in the dress. Just, look. You hold these, and imagine that you're standing on the altar, and you're looking at the guy that you're in love with. And just say what's in your heart.
I can't do this, Jonathan.
Yes, sure you can. Here, come on. Hold these, and you pretend that I'm the guy in the tux. The guy who you want to be with. The guy who you can't live without. You pretend I'm Sandy.
Jonathan.
Sandy.
Sandy, I can't wait to be your wife. Because when I'm with you, I feel so safe. Like everything's gonna be okay. Because I know you'll take care of me forever. You're so kind and generous and good. I can't do this.
No, you can't. Keep going. You're doing fine.
You are so optimistic. I could be having a really bad day or something really bad happened, and then I see your smile, and it's like the sun came out again. Suddenly the world's a hopeful place. A place where we can build a wonderful future together. There's more, but that's
pretty much how it goes.
Yeah. Yeah. It's it. My turn. Promise to keep you safe, because what we feel for each other isn't safe. It's dangerous. It threatens people, especially you.
Jonathan.
And I can't promise to obey you, because I'm not an obedient kind of guy. Truth is, I can't promise you much of anything except this. You will be the most important person in the world to me. The one. There will never be a day where I will stop wanting you or needing you or love.
Stop! Sandy's gonna be here any minute, and so is my mom, so you need to leave.
I'm not going anywhere until the lights come back on, because it's crazy out there.
I will be fine.
I'm not going anywhere without you.
Leave. I'll be okay.
Ira, you want me out of here? Fine. I'll leave. You're coming with me.
Put me down. We're inside. The dress will be fine.
There. You happy now? Light some more candles. You want something to eat?
No, I just want to call Sandy and tell him to pick me up.
Go for it.
I swear somebody set it up for everything to go wrong tonight.
Not everything.
What are you doing?
Making a sandwich.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm hungry. You?
I am, a little.
Well, good. Then I'll make you one, too.
No, not in this dress.
Take it off. Relax, I don't mean... Here, Ava keeps a change of clothes behind the bar, so it should fit you.
Thanks. Switch places with me?
Help you.
No. I'll just keep it on.
And be miserable?
I'm not miserable.
Don't you want to eat?
I don't even care anymore. JB, no.
Just... I'll get it started.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome. I like you better like this.
Want some?
Yes. You are so beautiful.
JB, no.
Come on. It's dark. You can do whatever you want in the dark. Nobody has to know.
No,
We don't have to stop.
Yes, we do. I do. I cannot believe I just let you do. This is so wrong.
Tammy, this is the only thing that's right.
How can you say that?
Hey, look at me. Look at me. Don't think too much. Fighting it doesn't make it better. Fighting it gives you time to think. Thinking can be dangerous. Tammy.
Don't say it. I am with Sandy. He's my life. Marrying him is the best decision I ever made.
What's this?
The biggest mistake. You can choose to live your life in the dark, but I choose the light.
The only person living their life in the dark around here is you. You don't want Sandy, you want me. But hey, walk out of here. Go marry him. Fine. You keep lying to yourself. If that's not living in the dark, I don't know what is.
Maybe I am lying to myself. But I love Sandy. I'm not gonna hurt him.
What do you think marrying him will do?
We're gonna be happy.
How? You won't be able to stay away from me.
Oh, hallelujah. The lights are on, the place is open. I need a drink.
Hi, Tammy. Hi, Reva. What are you doing here? Have you been crying?
I'm fine.
I just got stuck here in the dark. Is that your wedding dress?
It was, but I changed my mind.
Well, what's it doing here?
I really do. I have to go. I'm sorry.
Do you need a lift?
No, Sandy will come and get me.
How is that possible? You haven't been able to get in touch with the guy all day.
I'll keep trying.
I'll take you.
No, stay here with your mother.
You want to tell me what just happened tonight?
Not really.
Tammy seemed pretty upset.
I have that effect on people.